Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1402, SUMIF. Hey, all right, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jellin. This question sent in data here on sheet 2. They want to be able to choose a company in sheet 2, get the quantity, and then the average unit price. But we need a weighted average unit price because there's a different number of purchases. And it's funny, I looked at the spreadsheet, and here we have a SUMIF formula, and that works great to get the quantity. They're actually building a true SUMIF. But then for the total price, we're going back to hard coding values. And so I looked at this and said, okay, somebody who created this worksheet understands SUMIF. They then handed it off, or they left the company, and someone else is left and trying to figure out total price. It's as if we don't really even understand what SUMIF is doing. All right, so let's take a look at the SUMIF function here. SUMIF A2 to A15 that says, hey, cruise down through all of these values in column A and see if it's equal to E2, Microsoft. If it is, we need the corresponding value from B2 to B15. All right, so it'll add up, in this case, that 16 and that 13 and that 19 to get the total. So if we have that formula working, we can copy that. And I'm going to type an equal sign here and then paste Control V. That gives me two equal signs. Yeah, that's just me being silly because I don't like to have to retype the whole thing. A2 to A15, and this time we want to look and see if it's equal to E2, but we want to add up the corresponding value from D. So I take those B's and change them to D's. All right, so there's our answer. All right, you know, now the advantage here is if we add a new set of data, those will update without having to come back and retype these formulas. That's a much better way to go. And then the average here, just doing the simple division. Now back on this page, what we need to do is we need to come up with an average unit price. So, well, there's a couple of different ways to go. Let's just build it here. Equal SUMIF. And we can point to data on another worksheet. So I'm going to click on sheet 1 and choose everything in column A, A2 to A15. I'll press F4. F4 puts the dollar signs in, so that way that formula remains absolute. I want to see if that's equal to, here on sheet 2, I want to see if it's equal to the name that we type into A2, comma, and then if it is, we want to grab the corresponding value from column D, and again, press F4. All right, so that's the first half of our formula. That gets us the total revenue. Now we want to divide by the quantity. You know, actually, boy, at this point, I really have almost what I need here. I'm going to Control C to copy, divided by Control V to paste, and I realize we're outside of the window here. I'm going to come over to where it says D2 and change that to B2 and change D15 to B15 and press Enter. Now let's just do a little test here. We have our formulas that are working here. So Java 4.438, let's type in Microsoft, and 62. Then final test, Microsoft. 20 at, let's just go with 50. Microsoft updates here, 58.49, and updates there, 58.49. So it's all working. All right, so relatively simple formula, admittedly a very long formula with two sum ifs. But once you understand what the sum if is doing, then everything else just falls into place. Okay, well, hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. See you next time for another next.